'Tis all my doing. I believed myself the only one who truly understood Eorzea's woes, and look what that arrogance has wrought. I gave commands, influenced governments with my certainty. I treated the Crystal Braves, and even the Scions themselves, as pawns in my great scheme to save the realm. But in my headlong rush into imagined glory, I paid no heed to the ground upon which I trod. The salvation of Eorzea. What was it that I hoped to achieve? Did I believe that I could rid the realm of every danger and difficulty? That I could defeat the Empire and the Ascians? And find homes for every refugee? Oh, yes. I was so very clever. Become a guardian of Eorzea, I implored, and sat back to watch my perfect army cleanse the land of chaos. It was all but a means to feed my own vanity. Only when all is lost do I finally realize the truth.
Oh, Alfino.
So, Master Alfino, are you content to remain a broken blade? Is there no flame hot enough to reforge you? What of the fine companions who yet stand at your side? I dare say the fires of their determination will soon have you slicing the air again with your customary wit.
I hardly deserve such friendship. And besides, where are we to go?
Alfino, if I may? Should this place not serve our purpose, then we shall go to Ishgard. Minfilia told me many times, as long as we stand fast against despair, the beacon of hope will never be lost to sight. Be it in the snow or in the clouds, we few will see that the dawn's light shines again.
You are right, Totaru. Thank you. And thank you for your kind words, Lord Orshfong. Tis true that Eorzea yet has her guardians. The Scions have achieved much, and 'twould be remiss of me to discard it all in a fit of self-pity. Let us then resume our journey, together, one step at a time.
Shining is the land's light of justice. Ever flows the land's well of purpose.
Same fleeting moment.
All has been arranged as you desired, my lord.
Thou thinkest sanctuary lieth beyond. Delusion, despair, death. Thou shalt find naught else here.